Good morning, friends. My laptop says it is 7:19. It's Thursday. Is it Thursday? Yeah, I think it is. Let me scroll down here to see. Yes, Thursday. No vlog for a while, eh? And I woke up like this with my hairdo, and Mr. Levi, look at his hairdo. You see, I'm eating some Lucky Charms. here's my purse I bought last week. I've been to JCPenney's, and I bought this Nicole Miller. You can see my camera in there. I love her. She's cute. It's a crossbody. You can take this off if you want to, and I like that when I have it hanging from my shoulder, it stays in one spot, and it doesn't, like, you know, fall off. And I can also, strap it across my chest if I want to, which I don't ever really do that. And this is the back side. My phone fits in here perfectly. And it's like a powder blue. And online, when you look, it looks dark like my other purse that I did, or that I have. I didn't ever show it really, other than, I never did a what's in my purse, but, and I'm not doing one now, but it's got three, I didn't even know it had a zipper across this part, or this part right here. And then it's got the middle part, and I'm not crazy about these little things here, but it's there nevertheless. But that's kind of what it looks like right now. It's got another zipper thing there, but it does have the little regular pockets inside here. And the middle one right here, I just use to keep my checkbook and like a pen so that I can balance my checkbook. Because I do it often when I'm out and about in the parking lot. If I'm buying stuff, I like to just keep up with our checking account that way. And what else has been going on? Jaden got his spring pictures. I just hung it up there. Let me see if y'all can see it right there a little bit. It's not wanting to. It's kind of trying to focus a little bit, I reckon. But, anyway, I was home all day yesterday, and I'm going to be home all day today. Ooh. The situation with the house is not going to happen. We decided not to move where we were looking at for several reasons, really. One, it was about 15-20 minutes away. The opposite direction than where we want to live. And I don't know, I just felt weird about us putting the money down for it and everything before we can actually live in it, because our landlord will not let us out of our lease, because our lease is till October 2nd, so we'd have to pay all the way up through September or to September or something. We'd have to pay between $3,800 and $4,000 to get out of the lease. And the bad thing is the woman is one of these kind of people that I don't have nothing good to say about her, really. She'll, you know, talk to you to your face and bake you a casserole and then tell you where to go right after that. You know, she's really two-faced and stuff. And her husband is my husband's boss. And her husband is also the brother-in-law to my husband's youngest brother. So my husband's youngest brother, his wife is the sister to my husband's boss. So are y'all confused yet? And they are no good. And so it's kind of like we're under the man's thumb. The man actually, he's kind of okay at points, but when they called for a rental reference for the history, we had everything else done. Our banking, our background check, everything had been done. Only thing left was to get a rental history from our current landlords. And my husband's boss wouldn't even talk to the guy about it. He's like, oh, you need to talk to my wife. It's really her house, which in essence it is. It was her house before they got married. But on our lease, it has his name on there. So he basically put it off onto his wife. And when we moved in here, they, my husband was talking to his boss about it, and he's like, you know, we're not happy out there, it's too noisy, that main road out there. And the guy's like, well, if y'all want to move out, y'all can move out anytime y'all want to. And he's hated this house because he lived here with his wife before they moved to, and had a home built. Well, that being said, he's acting like he never said anything. Well, he's not really acting like he never said nothing, but he's all putting it on to his wife for us to deal with. And when my husband talked to her, she's like, yeah, you can get out of the lease. And she told the man that called for the reference that she'd work with us about getting out of the lease. Oh, yeah, she'll work with you, but you're going to pay the full amount to get out, in other words. So my husband was fine with actually doing that because he's desperate to let's get out of this house to get some sleep and stuff. And I'm like, no, no, no. That's a lot of money to just hand over to somebody. And, you know, and the thing is, we already had someone lined up for her to rent it to. That wasn't good enough either. She wanted that money to get out of the lease. So we are kind of like, unless we find a place where we're actually wanting to move to near my in-laws and it be jam up and worth paying to get out of here to break the lease, then we would do it. But the place we found was a little bit on the smaller side than what we're used to right now. And so, yeah, I'm not feeling desperate. And then the other thing is the mower that my husband got almost, I guess it's been about a month and a half, or almost 2 months or something. He got a used one from Aaron's. It's been a nightmare ever since we've had it. The battery or something always is going on with it. They tell you, oh, we're going to come out and do this, and I'd stay home, and then they wouldn't show up. Oh, we had you on the wrong day, and then they wouldn't come out on that day, and I'd stay home, and they didn't show up. And it was always something. So then my husband, when they finally did come out and replace the battery, my husband had like this much gas left in it to mow the grass, which was plenty. It wouldn't even crank. So he called him yesterday and told him to come get it. And the lady's like, oh, we can put you in a new one for 800 more or whatever it is. And he's like, no, thank you. I'll just go out right and buy one. So that's what we're going to do. We found a few online that are for sale, and they aren't brand new, but they're affordable and everything. And, you know, there was one he saw, it was like almost 600. One was like 1300. I forget what the other ones was. To me, I'm like, let the place grow up. We can't really let it grow up. And I don't know. So today when he gets off work, he may be leaving an hour early if the people still have the one he's calling about. And so we may be, yeah, we're getting a new mower, but I don't know if it's going to be today or when. But Aaron's supposed to come pick up the other one today by 3. We'll see if that happens. So that's one reason I can't go nowhere today. Got to be here for that little window of time. And Levi, what are you doing, boy? You got cereal on the table and on the floor. I heard some hit the floor. Y'all, he's eating Lucky Charms, and he does like any other kid and eats the marshmallows out first. And he doesn't have milk in the bowl. I don't do the milk in the bowl for kids when they're that age. Unless I'm feeding it to them directly or something. Yeah. Jaden actually doesn't care for milk in the bowl to this day. He likes his cereal dry, which is fine with me. Yeah. But I made beef stew and rice yesterday. Well, beef stew, my crock pot meal that I've got a video to it. I'll put it up here for y'all to look at. If you're just finding my channel and don't know, I put cooking videos up from time to time. Made that. Me and the kids had rice with ours, and my husband didn't get home till like a couple hours late. So, and he actually prefers, I mean, he'll eat it anyway, I give it to him, but if you got egg noodles in the house, that's how he wants his. He wants his on the egg noodles. So I actually only ate a little bit, and then I ended up eating a little bit more with the noodles with him after he got a shower. And so I'm trying to think what else I was going to tell y'all. I ransacked Jaden's room day before yesterday, threw away a ton of stuff. That boy has accumulated. He went birthday shopping with his money. He had like 90 bucks to shop with. And he bought a bunch. I took him to Toys R Us and Walmart and several things and several other places. And he bought some stuff. And then so I actually went in there and tried to redo his closet And I threw out this one big box that used to have our stroller in it. It came in like a big box, and my husband had cut it in half, and it was two toy boxes at one point. And I got rid of one part of it. Well, yeah, the day before yesterday, I got rid of the other half. Noah's just got a small laundry basket in his room, in his closet, with just a few things in it. And yeah, I think it's plenty. Because I was kind of like, you know, getting it to where when we do move, we got less trash and all, because a couple of things he has in his room, he's obsessed with, like, recycle trucks and garbage trucks and that kind of thing. And so I had to get the garbage out of his room. And when I say garbage, it's like pieces of paper and all that he balled up and made into garbage, because his one truck actually is like, it works like a real garbage truck and dumps it and everything. And that's the one we got at Toys R Us. It's really big. But and I had to get his Legos in order. He's got several things in the Legos now. There was something else I got in order, and his ugly pets. If y'all aren't familiar, it's kind of like, I think, Little Pet Shop, but it's like for boys. And it's the ugly pets. So they're like, their tongues hanging out and their eyes are popping out of their head and they're puking on themselves. And so, you know, it's just, I don't know. But it kind of, the one I got him had the portable car wash or whatever, the van, that, and it's loud too, that thing that it does. But he plays and plays and plays with that thing. And I had bought him extra little ugly pets to go with it. And so I gave him a bag to, and I labeled it to keep him in when he's not using it. So I'm trying to teach him how to keep your stuff in order. And, you know, when you're done with one thing, put it up before you move on to the next thing to play with. And he's kind of getting it. And then he forgets, you know, but it is what it is. So anyway, the house that we were looking at, I loved the layout of it, but it just really was a little bit too small for us. But it had a lot of acreage with it. That was a plus. And a creek ran through it, but through the back of it. But anyway, we're just gonna keep looking and not be desperate, and you know, the money we've got saved up in the bank, just keep adding to it. Minus the little bit my husband's gonna use to buy the mower with. You know, we're not gonna touch it or anything. But I don't know about my vlogging style today. Yesterday I didn't get a shower until like, it was after Jaden got home. 2 days in a row I did that. Day before that I did it too. I tried to go through my closet last night right before my husband got home, but then he called and then I couldn't get off the phone with him. He's just like that. So I didn't really get it done. Are you ready to get up, buddy? So I'm sitting here dealing with that one. Yeah. What is it, Levi? He's got out all his toys, some there. He's just, he was laying on the floor pitching a fit here about something. What are you doing? Come here. Oh, I don't know what he's crying about. He's got a new thing he does lately. He'll walk on his tiptoes. And then you can say, spin like a ballerino. And he'll just start spinning in circles on the floor. And my husband's like, you're turning him into a girl. Levi. Hey, buddy. Can you spin like a ballerino? Can you spin like a ballerino? He says no. Oh. Levi. This is real life, y'all. So, yay, it's glorious me. I finally got a shower, put Levi down for a nap, gave him some toast. He seemed like he was still a little bit hungry. He got up early this morning right after Jaden and my husband left. So, when he does that, he always takes an early nap for some reason. So, I went ahead and gave him a little something on his stomach and jumped in the shower and am contemplating what I'm going to do today. And I still got to figure out what I'm making for dinner. So, and if you want to catch it, I did a review on a collagen mask that did not work out for me. and here's a link up here for it. By the time you see this, it will have already been posted anyway, so you may have already seen it. But anyway, it looks like a good day, glorious day outside, even though it's supposed to rain, I believe, today. But it doesn't look like it right now. Yeah, so that's what's going on right now. Hey y'all, so I've been here playing with Levi, doing little selfie pictures and stuff. And I'm trying to coax him to pick his stuff up, because he's just got random stuff here on the floor, things around here. And my kitchen's a mess because I decided to go ahead and bake cookies. And then Aaron's just called and said they were on their way over here to pick that lawnmower up. And my husband told me he was on his way to the next town over to take a look at the mowers that he called about one that they had others apparently too. So he's got a trailer in case he finds one he wants. He's just gonna call me to move some money over out of savings and a checking so that he can, I guess, pay for it with a debit card. Well, but he's even got a check with him, so he'd have to do it that way. I think it's a business too. So I did get cookies made today. Look at them, y'all. These are my Rachel Ray pans that my stepson JT got me at Christmas, and I love them. They are groovy times 10. Speaking of pans, I got some new pans. That one's actually just had a grilled cheese cooked in it a while ago. These are clean right here. This is one of the smaller ones. And it's made by Invitations. I got them at Best Buy, and I think they were regular $49.99. The 20% coupon and all that kind of stuff made it like $40 or something. Plus, I bought a set of whisk. I bought, this is actually one of them here, and then there's a smaller one that I don't have right here handy to show you. But speaking of, my husband, it was the pots and pans were Mother's Day gift. He was going to get me some the night before Mother's Day. We went to the Walmart, and I just couldn't decide on any that I wanted. I really wanted to research them. Levi, get down. And let me get him real quick. He's got my mirror. I don't even know why I got a mirror in here. Okay, you got to get down, Bubba. I'm about to have to put him in his room. Hang on. Okay, I'm back. I had to go put him in his room and then fix the gate. Anyway, what I was going to show you was, okay, I was telling you about pots and pans. I couldn't find any I really wanted. I really wanted to research them. Those ones that look like ceramic, like they're white on the inside, look really good. I like the way they look. But I just read too many reviews after I researched it of them not being nonstick after a few months and staining really bad and blah, blah, blah. And I didn't really want to get black pots and pans. I didn't really want red because I've been down that road. And I still have my current Paula Deen ones that are like that robin egg blue, turquoisey color. So I'm still using them for backup. But in the meantime, my husband, we were looking and he picked out these wooden spoons. That one there's got a bear scene on it. I don't even know if it's there. You can kind of see. And then that one's got like ducks on it. I've already washed them. They're the Mossy Oak brand. That man, I tell you what. And then he found, he's like, oh, you need a spoon rest. He got me a Mossy Oak spoon rest to go in my kitchen. I mean, I've seen some of that kind of stuff. I just haven't picked it up because I didn't think it would go. But my husband thought I needed it. So therefore, I own it now. And that's real sweet of him. He wanted me to get a pressure cooker. I said, no. I'm terrified of them things. I mean, I know I shouldn't be now because they're digital and everything. The one my mother-in-law's got, I've heard too many horror stories. And I'm just like, you know, I'm just now getting on the, you know, crock pot, slow cooker kind of thing going on, let alone, you know, trying something else. No, but in the meantime, I also, we was at Ollie's, I got some of these brass, I got dough on me now, what do you call it, measuring cups, and then some of the measuring spoons. And when I first washed these, I had them soaking, they had a weird smell about them, like a, almost like a fuel smell. There it is, for hang off. And I let them soak in some soapy water, and that we went off that evening to eat Applebee's. We went to Applebee's. See, I could have been vlogging. And we, oh my God, it was so good, y'all. And they were offering us free dessert, which we were too full to eat, and we just opted not even take it home with us to even order it or whatever. But my husband was wanting to leave a $10 tip, and I'm like, for this man, for this guy, and he, I mean, he did good. I said, baby, he's good, but I mean, unless he's out there detailing my vehicle, I'm not leaving a $10 tip. We left him a $5 though, but my husband's always a big tipper. But it was so good, y'all. I had that Fiesta lime chicken that I've had. I haven't been to Applebee's in probably about 15 years. And that's about when I think they came out with that. And I couldn't believe they still had it. And my husband got a steak. He'd never had their steaks before. He loved it. And then Levi had their Kraft macaroni and cheese. He ate that. And Jaden had pizza. But I just get off on these tangents. I'm telling you what we did. But anyhow, I let those brass things there soak. And when we got back, they were soaking in actually a blue bowl like this one here. One of my husband's bowls that he's ice cream, chili, you know, cereal, whatever out of them. And it looked like there was like peach paint on them. And it was like, what in the world happened here? And it, I mean, as long as I put some elbow grease into it with the sponge, it scrubbed right off, but it wasn't like transferring from that to my sponge, which was weird. And I've used them a few times since then, and they haven't turned that cloudy color. So I'm not familiar with if brass does that. Y'all let me know if y'all know. But I'm fixing to get these cookies here scooped up and put them in a bag. And yeah, my husband likes to take them to work, and him and Levi munch on them at night after Jaden goes to bed. And I ran out of regular flour, and I had a substitute about a cup, a little bit less than a cup of bread flour. And I was afraid they weren't going to turn out, because when they came out of the oven, they looked puffy like cake looking. And now they've kind of calmed down. But if it turns out good, I might have to substitute it again next time. But these have chocolate chips and the mini M&Ms in them. And they're looking delicious. I haven't eaten one yet, but I'm sure they're right on time. And so, yeah, I'm waiting for errands to get here. I'm just looking out my kitchen window. I got the blinds open up here. Just looking out my kitchen window. I need to go out there and check my mail. And yeah, so, and then, so I'm actually in here fixing to do this little bit of dishes and put those away. So then my kitchen will be back to normal. Yeah, so, yeah, I think I might call it a vlog, because I still don't even know what I'm making for dinner yet, and I need to sit down and figure that out. But I only because I'm ending it now, because I know that this vlog is already super duper long. So I will see you guys next time. Bye, y'all.